नियति कृत नियमरहिता प्रादैकमया अरण्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. विल् हाव् टु स्टार्ट् वित् द 10th चाप्टर् विच् इस् जस्ट् अर्थालङ्कार. अर्थालङ्कारान् आह साधर्म्यम् उपमा भेदे उपमान उपमेययोः एव न तु कार्यकारणादिकयोः साधर्म्यं भवति इति तयोरेव समानेन धर्मेण सम्बन्धः उपमा भेदग्रहणम् अनन्वयव्यवच्छेदाय. फस्ट् ही एनी आलङ्कारिका हू स्टार्ट्स् विद् अलङ्कारास् आल्वेस् से फस्ट् एक्स्प्लेन् उपमा अलङ्कार बिकास् इट् इस् द सिम्प्लेस्ट् आफ् अलङ्कारास् दट् वी केन् अण्डर्स्टाण्ड्. So the first thing and a lot of alankaras are based on upama. Upama shailushi eva. It is like a, you know, an actress who just, upama is like an actor who takes on different roles. So the same upama, upama means similarity between two objects. You are comparing two objects, say a mukham and kamalam. When you are comparing the two objects, there is something which is beautiful and accepted as beautiful in the whole world. It is the upamanam. It is like a standard of comparison. That is what you use. It is a popular object. Upamanam is a prasiddha vastu. And then upameyam is that which has to be described or that which has to be compared. Upameyate asau iti upameyaha. That which is being compared is your upameyaha. Upamanam is upameyate anena. With this object, you are comparing the present context. So these two, there is a difference between the two. Nobody is going to look at a mukham and say, this is lotus. There is a difference between the two, but there is also a similarity. Just like how when you look at a lotus, you feel happy or you're attracted towards it. There is a lovely color to it. There are so many aspects that remind you of the lotus when you look at the mukham also. So the mukham is also beautiful to look at. It has so many nice qualities to it. And so you compare the two of them. So there is a sadharmyam, sadharmaha, samanaha, tulyaha, dharmaha, iti sadharmano. Those two objects which have a common dharma, common quality is called sadharma. Sadharma is an object. Sadharmano are two objects which have a common quality. And tayoho bhavaha sadharmyam, similarity. So you have to have an upamanam, upameyam, and then sadharmyam. There is also another fourth one, which is upama vachakaha or upama pratipadakaha, that which tells us that upama, the two objects are being compared, like eva, vat, yatha tatha, atava sadrishaha, tulyaha, iti kamalena sadrishaha, kamalena tulyaha, kamalena tulyam mukham, those tulyam or sadrisham, these are the words that give us the idea that two objects are being compared, that there is an upama here. Okay, so there is a difference between the two objects, yet there is a similarity. So sadharmyam upama bhede sati, when there is a difference between the upamana upameyayoho eva bhede sati sadharmyam upama alankaraha. Now this upama alankara, when you look at rupakam, because based on that similarity that you have, you just say mukameva kamalam. This is not, this is the face is the lotus here. So then that becomes rupakam. It is actually based off of rupa, upama. Upama is like one underlying thing for many alankaras like that. If you look at apannuti, no, this is not the face. It is actually a kamalam there. You are negating something, then it is apannuti. In that manner, you have many different alankaras. There is another alankara called ananvaya alankara, which is upamana upameyatve ekasyaiva ekavakyage. In the same sentence, if the same object is being compared to itself, I am not comparing mukham with kamalam. I am only saying mukham, mukhasya upama, mukhasya tulyam mukhameva. If I use both upamanam and the upameyam as the same object, that is called ananvayam. Then there is no bhedam between the upamana and the upameya. So in order to say that upama is different from ananvayalankara, he uses the word bheda in the definition. So bheda grahanam, difference, the word different is being used in order to, you know, so that you don't confuse it with the Ananvaya Alankara. In Ananvaya Alankaram, the example is Gaganam Gaganakaram. The sky can be compared only with sky. Sagaraha Sagaropamaha. The ocean can only be compared with the ocean. Rama Ravanayor Yuddham, Rama Ravanayor, nobody else can fight a Yuddham like how Rama and Ravana fought. So their Yuddham can be compared only to Rama Ravana Yuddham. This is called Ananvaya Alankara. That there the Upamana and the Upameya are the same. Okay. So Bhedagrahanam. Upamana Upameyayoho Eva. Now I have not dealt with that Karyakaranadikaha. I'll come there. So Tayoho Samanena Dharmena Sambandaha. साधर्म्यं भवति उपमान उपमेययोः एव साधर्म्यं भवति तयोरेव उपमान उपमेययोः एव समानेन धर्मेण सम्बन्धः उपमा भेदग्रहणम् अनन्वय व्यवच्छेदात् सो दट् इट् डस् नाट् वि डोण्ट् कन्फ्यूस् इट् वित् अनन्वय अलङ्कार वि हाव् टु हाव् द वर्ड् देर् इस् अ डिफरेन्स् बिट्वीन् उपमान एण्ड् उपमेय नौ वाट् इस् दिस् कार्यकारणभावम् कार्यगुणः कारणगुणम् अनुसरति What is karyam and karanam? Karanam is cause, karyam is effect. You have mud and you use the mud to make a pot. You have gold, you make ornaments with it. Whatever the quality is there in the karanam, the same quality is continued in the karyam also, in the effect also. The cause, the quality in the cause is similar to the, is continued or is similar to the quality in the karyam, then every sthalam, whatever we see, you know, then we'll have to say that even my gold earring is one alankaram here. Not alankara means not babushanam, but it is a upama. I'll have to say then, you know, even cloth is upama because the colors that are there in the thread has been translated into the color of the cloth. So karya gunam karana gunam, they both are similar. That is not a kavipratibha kalpitaha. It is not a chamatkara yuktam. So we are only talking of upamana and upameya sadharmyam, not the sadharmyam that exists between karya and karana, cause and effect. Okay, now the next karika is purna luptacha. This is a divisions of upama. उपमान उपमेय साधारण धर्म उपमा प्रतिपादकानाम उपादाने पूर्णा उपमा नाउ देयर आर टू फर्स्ट उपमा इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पूर्णा एंड लुप्ता पूर्ण उपमा इज वेयर ऑल द फोर एस्पेक्ट्स आर प्रेजेंट व्हाट आर द फोर एस्पेक्ट्स उपमान उपमेय साधारण धर्म एंड उपमा प्रतिपादक और उपमा वाचक शब्द एनीथिंग दैट गिव्स अस द आइडिया दैट देयर इज उपमा हियर That is Upama Pratipadakam. All four are present. Chaturnamapi Upadane Sati Purna Upama Iti Manyate. Ekasya Athava Dvayoho Athava Trayanam Lope Sati Lupta Upama. If one is absent, then also it is called Lupta. Lupta means something is absent there. If either the Upamana is not present, Upameya is not present, or the Sadharana Dharmam is not present, or Upama Pratipadaka Shabdaha is not present, then it is Lupta. If by combination any two is not present, Upamanam Upameyam is not there, but Sadharana Dharmam and Upama Vachaka Shabda is there, or Upameya and Upama Vachaka Shabda is there, in like this, there can be any sort of combination, or three of them is not there, only the Upamanam is there. Then also you can have it as luptopama. It is called luptopama. Sa agrima. Agrima means the first one. Purnopama is divided into two. Shrauti, arthi cha bhavet. It is further divided into shrauti and arthi upama. Shrauti purnopama, arthi purnopama. Each one of these are again divided into vakye, samase, taddhite. So it is either vakyaga, samasaga or taddhitaga. If it is present in a sentence, then all aspects are present in a sentence form. It is called Vakyaga, Shrauti Upama or Arthi Upama. There is a difference between Shrauti and Arthi. We will, he will give us the difference in the next paragraph. Okay. So it is further divided into Vakyaga, Samasaga, Tadditaga. Arthi Upama is also divided into Vakyaga, Samasaga, Tadditaga. So Purna Upama has six varieties like this. Shadvidha Purna Upama. Yatha. इव व आदि शब्दाः यत्पराः तस्यैव उपमानता प्रतीतिः इति यद्यपि उपमानविशेषणानि एते तथापि शब्दशक्तिमहिम्ना श्रुत्या एव षष्टीवत् सम्बन्धं प्रतिपादयन्ति इति तत्सद्भावे श्रौति उपमा तथैव तत्र तस्य इव इति अनेन इवार्थे विहितस्य वतेः उपादाने द लास्ट् सेण्टेन्स् इस् फार् जस्ट् द वति प्रत्यय वति इस् अ प्रत्यय विच् इस् अ तद्धितप्रत्यय एण्ड् वत् इफ् ऐ से मुखं चन्द्रवत् अस्ति the face is like the moon but I'm using vat as an indicator for upama and that vat is a taddhita pratyayam so that will become a taddhitaka upama here eva va ityadi shabda va is also just it can be used as va in a sentence it is used very rarely in some raghuvamsha shlokas there is that va usage सो इव व आदिशब्दाः यत्पराः उपात्ताः यत्पराः मीन्स् इफ् मुखं कमलम् इव मुखम् इफ् ऐ यूस् इव आफ्टर् ए सर्टन् शब्द देन् दट् सर्टन् शब्द विल् बिकम् दि उपमानम् सो मुखं कमलमिव इति यत् परं कमलपरं यत् इव शब्दः उपयुज्यते वेन् वि यूस् इव शब्द आफ्टर् कमलं देन् दट् कमलम् इस् उपमानता प्रतीतिः वि अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दट् दट् कमलम् इति शब्दः उपमानम् इति प्रतीतिः भवति सो उपमानता प्रतीतिः यद्यपि उपमानविशेषणानि एते See, it is actually mukham kamalam iva. Visheshanam means you have to have both in the same vibhakti. Mukham and kamalam is in the same vibhakti. It is not in another vibhakti. But we hear it as kamalasya iva mukhamapi akarshanam asti. Mukhamapi sundaram asti. So kamalasya iva. We hear it as a shashti, sambandham. The qualities of kamala. That shashti sambandham is heard. Hence it is श्रुत्या सो दट् षष्टिसम्बन्धम् इस् ए डैरेक्ट् एक्स्प्रेशन् सो इट् इस् काल्ड् श्रौति उपमा श्रौति पूर्णोपमा सो शब्दशक्ति महिम्ना बै द फोर्स् आफ् दट् वर्ड् बै द फोर्स् आफ् द वर्ड् कमलम् इव एण्ड् इट् इस् लैक् एन् उप विशेषणम् ईवन् दो इट् सीम्स् लैक् अ विशेषणं मुखं कमलम् इव एण्ड् वेर् मुखम् एण्ड् कमलम् आर् both in the same vibhakti it seems like it is an adjective tathapi shabda shakti mahimna shrutya eva shashtivat sambandham pratipadayanti all of these upamanas give us that relationship like how we say pragnyah purushah athava mama pustakam tasya vidyalayah iti shashti vibhakti sambandha atra spurati तथा मुखे कमलस्य आकर्षणम् अस्ति इति सम्बन्धः तत्र प्रतीयते इति कारणात् श्रौति उपमा तत्सद्भावे श्रौति उपमा सो वेन् वेन् यु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् अ षष्टि सम्बन्धं देर् बिट्वीन् दि उपमान एण्ड् दि साधारणधर्मं दट् इस् प्रेसेण्ट् इन् द मुखम् इन् दि उपमेयं देन् इट् इस् श्रौति उपमा तथैव तत्र तस्य इव दिस् इस् अ सूत्रम् पाणिनीस् सूत्रं विच् इस् तत्र तस्य इव इति सूत्रेण सो वेन् यु हेव् एन् एक्स्प्रेशन् मुखं कमलस्य इव यु केन् हेव् समासं बै सेयिङ्ग् कमलस्य इव केन् जस्ट् बिकम् अ समासं वेर् दट् विभक्ति इस् still retained kamalasyeva can be a samasam there okay instead of that kamalasyeva that is samasaga and instead of eva can be replaced by vat and you say kamalavat that is taddhitaka so three types one is if I just use it in a sentence mukham kamalam eva okay then it is just a sentence and that is vakyaga Shrauti Upama. If it is in a samasam, how do we say it? Mukhasya Akarshanam Kamalasyeva. And that Kamalasyeva is actually a samasa which is made by the Sutram Tatra Tasya Iva. Tasya Iva, where that Iva, Ivarthe, I think it is Ivena Nitya Samaso Vibhakti Alopaha Purvapada. The last line in this paragraph is Ivena Nitya Samasaha Vibhakti Alopaha Purvapada Prakriti Swaratvam Cha. With that, you have a Nitya Samasam and you will have Kamalasyeva becomes a Samasa by itself, and that will be a Samasaga Shruti Upama. The same way, instead of Iva, Tatra tasya iva, actually you remove the iva and put vat in place of that, which is a taddita pratyayam, and that becomes a tadditaka shruti upama. Okay, tatra tasya iva iti anena sutrena ivarthe iva shabdasya ivarthe vihitasya vatehe upadane. So instead of Iva shabda upadanam vina vat shabdam. Instead of Iva shabdasya vat adeshaha bhavati tatra. So instead of Iva, you use vat. Okay. Now we move on to Arthi Upama. Arthi Upama will not have this word Iva. It will be more like Tulyam, Sadrisham. These are the words that will be used. And when you use those words in the sama, in the sentence, you will not. You should not use the Shashti Vibhakti, but you will be using the Tritiya Vibhakti in that. Tena Tulyam Mukham Ityado Upameye Tat Tulyam Asya. So, say Tena Tulyam Mukham. Tena Tulyam Kamalena Tulyam Mukham Ityado. When we say the Mukham, face is equal, can be equated to Kamalam. That is another way of expressing it. So if Iva Shabda is present, is it Shrauti Upama? If you have an expression where it is Tena Tulyam, Adhava Tat Tulyam, Kamala Tulyam, Asya Mukhasya Sundarata Asti, Mukhasya Sundarata, that Shashti Vibhakti is not counted here. Tat Tulyam is only Kamalena Tulyam Asti. The Tritiya Vibhakti will come. Or Idam Cha Tatu Cha Tulyam Iti Samanam. If we say in both of them are equal, then there is a samanata there. Idam mukham tat kamalam cha tulyam samanam sadrisham. That is also arthi upama. Iti ubayatrapi tulyadi shabdanam vishrantihi. So vishrantihi means we go and end in the tulya. When we are talking about it, it is equal. That is where the ending of the sentence or the meaning of it goes to tulyam. Iti samya paryolochanaya tulyata pratitihi. Iti sadharmyasya arthatvat. The sadharmyam or the sadharana dharmam that is there between the two is we can understand it only by meaning. Mukena tulyam kamalam. The Sadharana Dharmam is not given there. We have to understand it from the meaning of it. It is not directly given. Whereas there you will say, Mukham Kamalam Iva Shobhanam. It has to be present. Or if it is not present, we understand it that it expects. The Shabda, the word Iva, has an Apeksha for the Sadharana Dharma. Here the Apeksha for the Sadharana Dharmam is more by how we understand it. Okay, so for a simple purpose, you can take it as Iva Va. These when these words are used, then it is Shrauti Upama. If the words Tulya, Sadrisha, Samana, etc. are used, then it is Arthi Upama. Tadvate. In the same manner, just like how we saw, instead of Iva, we can use Vat Pratyayam. The same way, Vat Pratyayam can also come Tena Tulyam Kriya Chetu Vatihi. If we, instead of Tulya, we can use Vat Pratyayam also. It depends on the samasam. We should know grammar for that. And only then we can understand where this Vat Pratyaya has come for Iva or whether this Vat Pratyaya has come for Tulyam. If it has come for Iva, then it is Taddhitaka Shrauti. If it has come for Tulyam, then it is Taddhitaka Arthi Upama. For samasaka, ivena nitya samasaha vibhakti alopaha. Vibhakti alopaha, the vibhakti is still remains like bhujairiva, kamalasyeva. The vibhakti still remains and we don't just say kamaleva or bhujeva. We don't combine it into a samasa and say that. But we say, will along with the vibhakti, and that is samasaka for Shrauti Upama. For Samasaga Taddita Upama, we use something like Sadrisham. Surataru Sadrisham is the example he is going to give now. Surataru Sadrisham, if the word Sadrisha, Tulya, etc. comes within the Samasa, then it is Samasaga Arthi Upama. Okay. Kramena Udaharanam, for each one he is going to give. First he is giving Vakyaga Shrauti, then Vakyaga Arthi. He's just continuously giving five examples, where the first two are Vakyaga, the next two are Samasaga, and then the last one has Taddhitaga in the for both Shrauti and Arthi in the first line and the second line. So the first example is Swapne Samare Swapnepi Samareshu Tvam Vijayashrihi Na Munchati Prabhava Prabhavam Kantam Swadina Patika Yatha. This is Vakyaga Shrauti Purnopama. Swapanepi samareshu samareshu tvam vijayashrihi namunchati samareshu vijayashrihi. The victory vijayashrihi, vijayalakshmi, you get the victory vijayalakshmi, you attain it in the battlefield. So a kavi is praising the king here. So vijayash samareshu vijayashrihi, your victory in the battle does not leave you. Tvam namunchati, it does not even leave you and go. Tvam na tyajati kutra swapane api, even in your dreams that victory does not let go of you. Sometimes we dream that we have lost everything. No, even in the dream that Vijayashri is always with you. Prabhava prabhavam kantam swadina patika yata. Tvam, the prabhava prabhavam kantam is both an adjective for the raja and kantaha a pati. Just like how a Pativrata stri is very devoted to her pati, to her husband, and she does not leave him, does not think about leaving him even in the swapnam. Swadhina patika means one who yasyaha patihi sva adhine vartate. One whose husband is under her control, or one whose husband is devoted to her. If the husband is devoted to her, swa adhina patika chete, she is also devoted to him, because he is kantaha, he is very attractive, and prabhava prabhavam, he also showers his prabhava. Prabhava means his effect. He has a very great effect on her. So he is devoted to her, and he also has a great effect on her. Then this swadhina patika, this woman, will never let go. Na munchati tam patim na munchati yatha. In the same manner, this Vijayalakshmi, Lakshmi also, victory, does not leave you, because prabhava prabhavam, she is attracted by your prabhava, by your prowess. And so you are kantaha, you are like a lover to her, to that Raja Lakshmi or that victory, Vijayalakshmi. Jayalakshmi does not let go of you at all. So here the upamanam is Swadhina Patika. Just like yatha swadhina patika na munchati, tatha vijayashrihi api na munchati. That is how the similarity goes here. So swadhina patika is your upamanam. Upameyam is the vijayashrihi. Sadharmyam is na munchati. Adava aparityagaha. Parityagam na karoti itya. Ayam dharmaha eva samanaha. Upamana upameyoho. Upama pratipadaka shabdaha cha atra eva. If you see that, swadhi, or not eva, it's actually yatha. Sorry, not eva. I made a mistake there. Swadhina patika yatha. That yatha is your upama pratipadaka shabda. Next is vakyaga arthi upamana. This is vakyam, right? This is not a samasa, nor is there a taddita pratyaya there. So it is a purna sentence where there is upama, there is an upameya, there is sadharmyam, and the upama pratipadaka shabda. Next one is Vakyaga Arthi Upama, where you should remember that Tulyam word should be there, or Samam. Some of these words, Sama, Samana, Tulya, Sadrisha, these are the words that should be present. Chakita Harina Lola Lochanayaha Krudhi Tarunaruna Tara Hari Kanti Sarasijam Idam Ananam Cha Tasyaha Samam Iti Chetasi Sammadam Vidatte. Kaschana Nayakaha Chetasi Manasi Sammadam Harsham Vidatte Santosham Karoti. Sam Nayaka is very happy and he is saying that, you know, Tasyaha Ananam, Nayika's face, Idam Ananam, सरसिजसमं, सरसिजम् इदम् आननं, तस्याः आननं समम्। इदं सरसिजम् इस् लुकिङ्ग् एट् अ लोटस् एण्ड् सेयिङ्ग् तस्याः आननं समम् इदं सरसिजम्। हर् फेस् इस् ईक्वल् टु आर् दिस् हर् फेस् इस् ईक्वल् टु दिस् सरोजं, दिस् लोटस्। सो शी तस्याः एड्जेक्टिव् इस् चकित हरिण लोल लोचनायाः तस्याः। हर् ऐस् आर् शी हेस् द she has eyes like a frightened deer, chakita harina, like a frightened deer, lola, it is sanchala lochana yukta sa, tasyaha nayikayaha krudhi, during anger her face is so red, taruna aruna tarahari kanti, tarahari kanti means it is kanti, it is so beautiful and attractive, hari her, she's got a kanti, she's got luster, her face has the luster which is hari, which is very beautiful, which is attractive, like the taruna aruna tara, like a red, taram means necklace, like a aruna red necklace, her face is so beautiful like a red necklace, or it is so beautiful like the dawn, aruna, arunodayam is that which comes before the suryodayam. Before Suryodayam, you have Arunodayam, which is very reddish, which makes the sky red in color. So, Tadrisha Aruna Iva Hari, Manohari Kanti Yuktam Ananam Mukham Tasyaha. Tat Idam Sarojam Samam, it is equal to this Sarojam, this Kamalam. So, even in anger, her face is so beautiful like the Kamalam, lotus. Iti Chetasi, in his mind, that Nayaka feels very happy by saying this. So here it is, Samam is the word that gives us that Upama, Samam, equal. So Upamanam is Sarasijam, Upamayam is Ananam, Sadharmyam is Aruna Sadrisha Kanti. So that redness which is there in both the Saroja and her face is your commonality. Upama Pratipadaka Shabdastvatra Samam iti. Next is Samasaka, Purna Upama. The next example is for, first one is Shrauti Upama, the second one is Arthi Upama. Atyayatehi Niyamakaribihi Uddhatanam Divyaihi Prabhabihi Anapayamayaihi Upayaihi Shaurihi Bhujairiva Shaurir Bhujairiva Chaturbihi Adaha Sada Yaha Lakshmi Vilasa Bhavanaihi Bhuvanam Bhara. Main sentences, Shaurihi Chaturbihi Bhujairiva यः राजा नृपः चतुर्भिः उपायैः सदा अधः भुवनं बबार, इदं भुवनं बबार, अधः अधस् शब्द इस् अधः अधः अमु अमु, इट्स् टैप् आफ् प्रोनौन् वेर् यु से दिस् इदम् इति शब्दे. द किङ्ग् हू प्रोटेक्ट्स् दिस् अर्त् इद् अधः भुवनं बबार, सदा बबार, हि इस् आल्वेस् bearing the weight of this bhuvanam with chaturbihi upayaihi, by using the four upayas in a very proper manner. Four upayas are sama, dana, veda, danda. He uses these four upayas in a very proper manner and rules this earth. That is the main sentence. Just like shaurihi chaturbihi bhujairiva, just like how Krishna, shauri, shuraha is a Yadava Vamsha king, and his Pautra or his Vamshajaha is Krishna. So just like Krishna protects this entire earth with his four arms, he takes care of this earth with his four arms. In the same manner, this king also uses the four upayas, Samadana Veda Danda, and protects this earth. Adaha Bhuvanam Sada Babara, he always takes care of this earth. All of the other words are all adjectives which are slishta upama, slishta visheshanam, that is slesha yuktam. There are two meanings for each of the word. Ati ayatayhi, atyayatayhi, for the king, for first we'll take bhuja. So the very long bhuja he has, his arms are very long, Krishna's arms are very long. So ajanu bahu, his arms are until his knees. It is a samudrika lakshanam. Uddhatanam niyamakaribihi, one who is very garva, garva yuktaha danavaha asura niyamakari, he is he gives dandam, he gives punishment for all the asuras, he destroys the asuras. Uddhatanam niyamakaribihi bhuja, his arms destroy the asuras. Divyaihi prabhavaihi, he has a very alaukika kanti, very divine luster he has, his arms have. Anapayamayaihi, apayam is failure. Anapayamaya is, it's always successful. His arms are sarvada sapalaihi bhujaihi. Lakshmi vilasa bhavanaihi, Lakshmi always is there in his bhuja, on his hand. So Lakshmi, it is like a playing ground for Lakshmi. Lakshmi vilasa bhavanaihi chaturbihi bhujairiva. How all of these are now going to go for the upaya, king's upaya. Atyayataihi, ayatam means long. So it's very efficient and long standing for a long time, because he uses these four upayas in a proper manner. It extends and it gives phalam for a long time. Atyayataihi. Uddhatanam niyamakaribihi, he controls garvanam dandadayibihi upayaihi. If anybody is garvam, garva yuktam, if anybody is very arrogant, he punishes them. He keeps them under control, either by sama, dana or bheda, and then end is danda. Divyaihi prabhabihi, divyam means equal to divine or utkrishtam. It is very, it's got a great prabha effect, prabhavam. It has a utkrishta prabhavaihi upayaihi. Each of these upayas have a very great effect with the subjects. Anapayamayaihi, they are successful. Here, Lakshmi Vilasa Bhavanaihi means, because of the proper employment of the Samadhana Veda Danda, he is able to attain Lakshmi, Aishwaryam, or this Rajya Lakshmi. So, Rajya Lakshmi, very beautifully, she plays in his, it is like a bhavanam for Rajya Lakshmi. All these four upayas for the king is like a bhavanam. Now, Prakritam is Upama Alankaram. Upamanam is Bhujaha. Upameya is Upayaha. And the sadharmyam are all of the visheshanas are all the sadharmyam here. And then upama pratipadakaha is bhujairiva is a samasam. It is a samastapadam. And the sutram that he uses is ivarthena vibhaktyalopaha. Ivena saha samasaha vibhaktyalopaha purupada swaratvam cha. That is the vartikam that is used. It is not a sutra. I'm sorry. Sahasupa is the sutram, and under that sutram you have Katyayana Vartika, which determines this samasa. And because of that Vartikam, we have this samasam Bhujairiva. The next is samasaga arthi upama. Avitata manoratha patha prathaneshu praguna garima gita shrihi surataru sadrishaha saha bhavan abilashaniyaha kshitishvara nakasya. हे क्षितीश्वर त्वं कस्य न अभिलषणीयः भवान यू एवरीबॉडी वांट्स टू बी विद यू हु विल नॉट थिंक दैट यू आर डिजायरेबल यू आर नॉट डिजायरेबल एवरीबॉडी विल वांट यू कस्य न अभिलषणीयः अपितु सर्वस्यापि अभिलषणीयः स्पृहणीयः इष्टः त्वमेव सर्वस्यापि इष्टः कस्य न इष्टः त्वं. Then we are asking a question, who will say I don't like you? Everybody will say I like you. That's what it means. So what are the adjectives here? Surataru sadrishaha tvam. You are like kalpataru. So that itself is a samasa here, where sadrisha word is used. If sadrisha word is used, it is arthi upama. And that sadrisha has been used in a samasam. Surataru sadrishaha. Iti samasaha tatra upayujyate. So then that is samasaga arthi upama. Now, whether it is purna upama or not, let's see. Surataru is your upamanam. He is comparing the bhavan, raja, with the surataru, kalpaka vriksham. You are like a kalpaka vriksham, and you give everything to everybody, and so people are all praising you. So that people are all praising you, or you are attractive, both of these things are the samana dharma. So the Kalpataru also gives, it is like a wish, it is a wish giving tree. So if you go and wish for something, it is going to give you everything. The same way, if you go and wish for something and you want your desire to be fulfilled by the king, he was going to fulfill the desire. That desire fulfilling attitude is common to both. That is the sadhanya. And hence, everybody will like you. That sprihaniyatvam or abhilashaniyatvam, Ishtatvam is also the common quality between Kalpataru and Raja. Okay, now the shlokam is avitatha, avitatha true, satyam, satya manoratha or sapala, sapala manoratha patha prathaneshu, praguna garima gita shrihi, gita shrihi, your shrihi, your fame is being gita, is being sung in a very great manner. Praguna garima, garima, your greatness is sung very beautifully. Gita shrihi, shrihi means beautiful. It is sung in a very beautiful manner. You whose garima, greatness of praguna, because of your qualities, you have a greatness which is being sung everywhere in a very famous manner. People think you are very famous and they are all talking your praises. Praguna garima gita shrihi. Why? In what manner are they talking? Prathaneshu, in their katha. In their, they're all talking about stories of how their manoratha patha, their pathways of desire have been fulfilled. Avitatha. It has been fulfilled. All the desires have been fulfilled. So the katha of you fulfilling all our desires. Tvam sarveshamapi manorathana purayati iti esha katha sarvaihi giyate. The same way kalpataruhu api sarvesham manoratham purayati manorathana purayati iti kalpataroho prashamsa api giyate. Everybody wants to praise the kalpataru also. So you are surataru sadrishaha. Kasyana abhilashaniyaha, who will not like you? Everybody will like you. So the upamanam is surataru, upameyam is bhavan or the raja, sadharmyam is the two qualities I said, and then upama pratipadakaha is your samastapada. Next is tadvitaga. In this one shloka itself, both are there. The first half has shrauti upama, second half has arthi upama. Gambhirya garimatasya satyam ganga bhujangavat duralokaha sa samare nidaga ambara ratnavat. Again, a kavi is praising the king and he is saying ganga bhujangavat. Bhujangaha is a very peculiar verb. It is used in a very peculiar meaning here. Bhujangaha means vita sarpayoho bhujangaha. Vitaha is a Tamil we have a word kallakadalanbo. Upapatihi, one who is a secret lover, that is a bhujangaha. Or sarpa, also another meaning is snake. But here we take the upapatihi or rahasya kamukaha is the meaning we take for bhujangaha. So ganga yaha rahasya kamukaha kaha samudraha. Because Ganga's husband is Shantanu and Ganga's rahasya pati is samudra. So, because she goes and joins with samudra, right, in the ocean. Her real life pati is actually Shantanu, whose son is Chitrangada, Vichitravirya, and the Mahabharata, the kings all came from that dynasty only, Shantanu's dynasty. So Ganga Bhujangavat Gambhirya Garima Tasya Ragnyaha, that king's Gambhirya Garima, the greatness Gambhiryam, is like that of the Samudra. See, we use like that of Samudra. Ganga samudrasya gambhiryam iva gambhiryam tasya rajnyah asti iti shashti sambandha tatra vartate iti shrauti upama. Okay, so ganga bhujangavat, that samasa, that vat is your tadvita pratyayam, and the sutram which brings about that vat pratyayam is tatra tasya iva. So ganga bhujangasya iva becomes ganga bhujangavat, that is your compound word. So upamanam is ganga bhujangaha samudraha eva upamanam upameyam tasya rajnyaha raja eva upameyam atra sadharmyam gambhirya garima, the king's gambhiryam is like that of samudra. Satyam, it is true. Okay, the first sentence is over. Then the second one is taddidaka arthi upama nidaga ambara ratnavat saha samare duralokaha. Nidagaha is summer, ambara sky, ratnam jewel. The sky jewel is surya, suryaha. Nidage during summer, grishmakale, suryaha, yata dukhena drishyate. अथवा द्रष्टुमेव न शक्नुमः. इट् इस् डिफिकल्ट् फार् अस् टु लुक् एट् द समर् सन् इन् द सेम् वे इट् इस् वेरि डिफिकल्ट् टु लुक् एट् दिस् किङ्ग् ड्यूरिङ्ग् समरे ड्यूरिङ्ग् युद्धम्. Just like how during Grishma Kala, it is difficult to look at the sun, the same way it is difficult to look at this king. Duralokaha Saha. So this Saha Raja Nidaga Ambara Ratnavatu Suryena Tulyaha Saha Raja. Suryena Tulyaha Duralokaha Saha. So there you have the Tritiya Vibhakti. There is a instead of tulya shabda you have the vati vattu pratyaya tena tulyam kriyached vatihi iti sutra anusaram tulyarthe vattu pratyaya upayujyate. So then it is taddhitaka arthi upama. Okay, so with this purnopama examples are done, and there is a small discussion in the next paragraph which is actually I'll quickly go through, not much, is just saying, so I've just split the whole thing as Purvapakshi and Siddhanti. If you look at the text, the arrangement will be very different. It may be easier if you look at it this way. So Purvapakshi, he starts, see the idea of this entire passage is, in the first Ullasa, he said, Gunalankara Yuktam Abhyankyam Chitrakavyam. The definition of Chitrakavyam, you have Dvani Kavyam, Uttama Kavyam, Gunibhuta Kavyam is Madhyama Kavyam, and Adhama Kavyam is Chitra Kavyam. When defining Chitra Kavya, he said, Guna Alankara Yuktam and Abhyangyam Chitra Kavyam. If there is no Vyangyartha, or the Vyangyartha is not at all very difficult to understand, or completely it is not at all present, but it has a lot of Alankaras and the Alankara is beautiful, then it is Chitrakavyam. Okay, now in this examples, all of these examples, it is actually a Chitrakavyam according to Mammata. But the Purvapakshi says, see, there is definitely a Vyangyartha in all of these. If you take the first example, Yatha Swadhina Patika, Kantam Prabhava Prabhavam Kantam Swadhina Patika Yatha. The first line was Swapnepi Samareshu Swapnepi, totally forgot the shlokam here. Swapnepi samareshu, 1 minute, let me have that shloka. I got the second line. Tvam Vijayashrihi Namunchati. Okay, Swapnepi samareshu Tvam Vijayashrihi Namunchati Prabhava Prabhavam Kantam Swadhina Patikayata. So here स्वादेन पतिका कान्तं भजमाना यथा लोकोत्तरचमत्कारभूः तथा जयश्रीः त्वदासेवनेन इत्यादिना प्रतीयमानेन विना. Now there is definitely a Vyangyartha here. And what is that Vyangyartham? It is just like how a lady devoted to her husband is very beautiful, and it is not something that you find often today in this world. It connects very beautifully with the world today. Husband, you have to be devoted to your husband, but someone who is constantly with her husband, who is extremely devoted to her husband and all that, is something very beautiful and not found in the world. In the same way, Vikri Tvad Asevanena Jayashrihi Jayalakshmi, who continuously serves you, is also something which is beyond this world. So there is a Vyangyartha there. That is pratyamanartha. That lokottara chamatkaram is not present in the shloka. He just says, swadina patika yata kantam na tyajati. Just like how she does not leave her husband, in the same way, Jayashrihi, Jayalakshmi also does not leave you, O king, does not leave the king. That's all is your vachyartham. But there can be a pratyamanartham for some rasikas that swadina patika yata kantam bhajati. Just like how a wife serves her husband, that is very beautiful. In the same way, the victory, Jayalakshmi also serving the king is so beautiful. That pratiyamanam vina. Uktehe vaichitriyam. Vaichitriyam cha alankaraha. See, without that pratiyamanena vina uktehe vaichitriyam. Without that, there is you can't just say that the vachyartham is vaichitryam and the vaichitryam is only alankaram. Without that, how can you say this? Okay, so his idea is there is no chamatkara in this, only alankara. He is saying there is chamatkaram in the there is a pratiyamanartham, and you can't say that only alankara is chamatkaram here, and so this is chitralankara. It's a purupakshi stand. So the Siddhanti says pratiyamanena vina yadyapi uktehe vaichitryam nasti tathapi vaichitryam cha alankaraha tathapi atra asmin shloke dvani athava gunibhuta vyangya vyavaharaha nasti. Just because there is a pratyamanartha, you can't say this in that first shloka swapnepi samareshu, that there is vyangyam, or this because there is vyangyam it is dvani, dvani kavyam, it is an uttama kavyam, or because the dvani is slightly there is and it is not clear, asputam is another gunibhuta vyangya variety, it is a gunibhuta vyangya. You cannot say that it is a chitra alankara, chitra kavyam. Okay, just because there is a little bit of vyangyam, it doesn't mean that it is not chitram, it is a chitra kavyam, is the Siddhanti Paksha. Purupakshi again says vyangya samsparsha paramarshat atra charuta pratitihi. No, the beauty of the shloka is because of that slight suggestion that I said now. Just like how the lady is serving her husband, the same way Jayalakshmi is also serving you. That slight suggestion only gives a beauty to the shlokam. It, you can take that, right? That is what Purvapakshi is asking. Siddhanti iti chet na, na vyangya sparsha paramarshat atra charuta pratitihi apitu vachya vaichitra prasibhasat eva. It is only the vachyartha which is more beautiful, and the way he has arranged the words, the words he has chosen is what is more beautiful than any vengyartha that is there. But he slightly accepts the Purvapakshi and says rasadistu vengyaha artha. If there are places where the vengyartha is rasam, or if there is another alankara that is present, if in some manner it is suggested that this king is better than another person, or there is a vyatireka alankara suggestion there, or ninduti alankara, some alankara, nindastuti, something or the other is present. If there is another alankara, sarvatra abhyabhichari iti aganayitva eva tad alankaraha udahrataha. There can be places where rasa is suggested. There can be places where alankara is suggested, but I have quoted aganayitva. I have not quoted examples where rasapradhanam is there, or there is an alankara dvani. Like in fourth ullasa, we found alankarena alankaraha, vastuna alankara dvani. In those cases, I have not quoted those. Tad alankaraha udakrataha aganayitva eva. I have not considered all those. My main aim in this section, Mammata says, that his main aim in this section is only to highlight alankaras and give examples for that. Tadrahitatvena tu, tadrahitatvena ityukte rasa rahitatve athava alankarantara dvani rahitatve sati udakhriyamana. If I were to give examples which do not have even a little bit of rasa, or even some alankara dvani, then virasatam avahanti, then there is no nirasatvam vartate tatra, then there is no rasam at all, then it is not at all to be considered as a kavyam. So there will be some little bit of vyangyam, but you should not hold on to that vyangyam and say that only it is a vyanga pradana kavyam. It is a chitralankara. Purva apara viruddha abhidanam iti na chodaniyam. So do not try to purva apara viruddha abhidanam means purva apara viruddham means purvam avyangyam chitram ityuktam idanim tu savyangyam udahritam ityevam adi paraspara viruddha abhidanam. So I'm reading out from this line here. Na chodaniyam, na shankaniyam. So don't unnecessarily understand that. See, you said in the first ullasa that avyangyam chitram, gunalankaram avyangyam chitram. Now you are saying, I cannot even quote any examples without a little bit of yangyam. That little bit of yangyam should be there, otherwise it is nirasam. Then purva apara viruttam, you are contradicting your own statement. Don't think like that, because it is some sort of a little bit of rasam will be there. Vidyamanatve api, it is fine, but our concentration should be on alankaras. Okay, that is what is the main. So na chodaniyam ityukte, you do not unnecessarily analyze about why you are contradicting your own statement. Okay, so with this purnopama is he also gives another statement, tadvat dharmasya lope. Now next is luptopama. He starts off with luptopama, which is five types that we will deal with next class.